Hi there, it's Kaya from Kaichiko Crafts, and today I will show you this quick watercolor card because I know that sometimes we just don't have a lot of time to craft, and it's nice to know a technique that is quick but looks beautiful. I will start by stamping my images. I am using my DerWand watercolor paper and I'm using Versa Fine Onyx Black ink because it works perfect with watercoloring. I will just stamp these images randomly and I will just put it in the right bottom corner. And here you can see that I started coloring. All that I will do is that I will put my Zik marker directly to the paper and I will use a pink one and a yellow one. And then I will just spread the color around and I won't bother going outside the lines. That is actually what I want because I like to call this technique a messy watercoloring, because you are using watercolors and you are not really thinking much about going inside lines, and this is really quickly. As you can see, I just put the color down, spread it around, and this looks great. I will now heat set this up so when I am applying the gray around it, I won't pull the color out. You will see what I mean here. So I will again use the marker directly on my paper and this will give it a nice shadow. So I will use this gray marker, and if I would have my flower still wet, the pink or the green may bleed to the gray. And now when I finish the gray color up, I will just use my alcohol marker and I will just fill these empty spaces with some dots. This will give it a nice finished look. And here I will just make some splotches, and you can see that they are really small, but it brings the colors and the black nicely together. I will emboss my sentiment on a black cardstock and it will say happy birthday. I won't do anything special. I will dip it in my white embossing powder and I will heat set it and then of course cut it down to the perfect size. The only thing left to do is gluing everything together. I will make sure that I will use a lot of glue behind my watercolor piece because I don't want my paper to warp. And now I will just continue gluing this together. I will pop my sentiment up with some double-sided foam squares, and the last thing that I will add will be some sequins. I just felt that I need some sequins there because it finishes the card up. I am using my liquid glue and that's it. I waited it for the glue to dry and I will just pop this up on my card base. And that's it. This is a really simple card that is quick to make if you don't have time. And I know that this happens sometimes, even to me. So I hope you will try this messy watercoloring. Thank you so much for watching. See you next time. Bye bye.